pictures at the Biblical Gardens, and it's just amazing to me the amount of beauty that is in God's creation. And, you know, there's so many things in this world that's trying to get our attention. And it's just amazing to me how a place just like this can exist to just help us sit down and focus. You know, Mark is back there, you know, back at the chapel, kind of just focusing on the Lord and allowing me to run around and take pictures. Should happen whether you're a Sabbatarian or you're not. How even the sound of rushing waters can soothe you in a way you never thought it could. And what I love about this place is just the way that there's scripture everywhere. Reminder of the goodness and the greatness of God. Because I'm so fallible, I need mercy and grace. I'm very, very hard on myself a lot of the time. I'm very much a perfectionist. I'm very much a head thinker. Difficult sometimes when I mean I'm constantly doubting myself and constantly wondering if I'll ever be good enough. And that's when I need the grace and mercy of God. That's when I need to realize that God loves me when I mess up. He loves me. He even loves me if I don't do the traditional Sabbath. He loves me when I question Him. He never stops loving me. It says in the scriptures that we could never be separated from the love of God, ever. Nothing can separate us from His love. I have to believe that. Because otherwise, I go into this massive depression. That I have to do enough and perform enough for His love. And I don't think He works like that. And staying on the narrow path, it's not so narrow that it's razor thin and you can barely walk it. Because He says that His yoke is easy and His burden is light. He wouldn't make this walk so difficult that we could never do it. He just wants us to trust and love Him and listen to Him and follow Him. It's not rocket science. And to some that may seem like, you know, following Torah does that, I believe because Jesus is Torah, He was Torah for me, that if I behold and I focus on Him, and I behold Him, I will be more like Him. I'm not saying I have all the answers, but at least I'm asking the question. believes, just believes in him will not perish, but have everlasting life. And I believe he saved my life in ways that I couldn't even begin to explain on a video. Help me to know truth, your truth. I don't need a teacher, because you are my teacher. Lord, help me. Help me know the difference between revelation, personal revelation that a person gets about you, as opposed to a teaching, theological teaching in the Bible. That's the biggest thing that's so difficult to understand, God. Some revelations, and some people teach these revelations as if it was fact for everybody, but it may have been just a revelation for them. I mean, even Paul states that he received revelation that he couldn't share, though. The Spirit wouldn't allow him to share it. So much so that a thorn was brought in his side so that he wouldn't, in his passion, reveal the hidden things too soon. Say this. My heart is open and willing to learn, but I want it to come from the Lord directly and not through man telling me what the Lord should be saying, because then that's not a relationship with him. That's it's not a relationship with him.